Hi, everyone. Welcome to our Kids Church family experience. I hope you had a wonderful holiday celebration at Christmas with your family and friends. And here we are at the new year, our last weekend of the year. And also, it's my last weekend here on staff as the Kids Church pastor. And so I'd like to say farewell to you all and let you know how much I love all of you kids, love our families at CA. I'm not gone forever. You'll see me around. We're still going to stay connected to Christian Assembly as we love this place so much. It's our home. And so as we look forward to this weekend, I just wanted to say goodbye and wish you all the best. Love you, kids. Hey, enjoy this weekend. Enjoy our time together. Like us and share us. Are you ready? Here we go.
Happy New Year!
How do we celebrate New Year's?
By staying up all night long.
And we get sparkling cider.
Some people stay up till midnight.
I fell asleep a lot.
What happens at midnight?
The ball in New York City drops.
Everybody's happy. You celebrate.
It's weird when we have to K-I-S-S.
Yes.
Gross.
What are your New Year's resolutions?
Have sweets all the time.
A back butt. Change my name to Sparkly.
Every week, a movie night, a game night, and a Gilligan's Island night.
Have lots of time with my grandparents.
I would like to try wasabi.
I like to get a unicorn and bunnies.
What's the thing you want to do most with your life?
Want to be an NFL kicker?
Be the best cellist in the world and be the best Lego builder in the world.
Going to all the continents.
A missionary.
I want to ride a deer.
Pharmaceutical rep, because that's what my dad does.
Have like cool bedroom with like cool posters and a hot tub and a ladder in my closet and have like a secret lab.
Why is it not good to give up?
Then you'll never achieve what you could.
Even if you have some rough times, you don't give up, you keep going.
Someday you will get it. Don't ever say you can't get it.
If you give up, you might be missing out because one day you will get it. And it will be really awesome when you do.
How can you help someone to not give up?
Encouraging them, giving them advices for stuff.
Say, you're doing a good job.
I like to hug people and kiss them. And I'll give them a toy.
Then I'll say, I'll be your best friend. So come on. Since I can do it, then I will teach you how to do it.
Why does God change us?
Because he loves us.
He loves us so much.
He knows that we need to be changed sometimes, and he wants us to have a better life.
He doesn't want us to be lost. He wants us to come home to him.
How does God change us?
Puts all the good things in our hearts.
He changes us by giving us something to believe in.
Why is it important to give someone a second chance?
When you're giving someone a second chance, you're trusting them and believing in them.
So that we're like not caught up on something that we've done, we can't really move on.
To have a new beginning.
What would you tell someone who didn't believe God could change them?
That Jesus died on the cross for our sins.
And he can change you because he's Jesus.
Keep praying and he will change you. You will feel it.
Because you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you.
Happy New Year!
Happy New Year, everybody.
Happy New Year.
Hey, friends. I hope that you all had a fantastic Christmas. Thanks so much to all of you who celebrated in person with us. It was so fun to honor and remember that Jesus was born together in person. And I want to personally invite all of you who are in the area to join us for our in-person service next weekend. It's so great when we get to spend time together in person. And I just want to tell you that I would like you to come if you are able. It's so fun that at Christmas we get to be part of giving and receiving gifts. And it's a great reminder to all of us that Jesus is the greatest gift that God has ever given to us. He gave us this amazing gift to show us how much he loves us, and that is something we can be thankful for. So let's celebrate and worship God together for this wonderful gift.
Is alive. The empty cross, the empty grave. Life eternal, you have won the day. Shout it out, Jesus is alive.
Hey, friends. I need y'all to hop to your feet because we're about to play a little game I like to call
New
or Old. It's super simple. I'll give you two options. One will be
New
and one will be Old. You just have to decide which one you would rather have. If you'd rather have the
New
option, run to the left side of the room. If you'd rather have the Old option, then run to the right side of the room. Easy peasy. All right, let's see our first two options. Would you rather eat only
new
food you've never tried, or only eat
old
leftovers of food that you like? Remember, run to the left if you choose
new,
and run to the right if you choose
old.
I don't know about you, but I think I could live on cold pizza for quite some time. All right, let's try another. Would you rather only wear
new
shoes that are way too big, or only wear
old
shoes that fit but smell like stinky cheese? Run to the side you choose now. I'm definitely gonna take a pass on the stinky cheese shoes. That's definitely no gouda. Anyway, moving on. Would you rather get a
new
toy every day, but never get to watch TV? Or get to watch as much TV as you wanted, but only on a really
old
TV? To TV or not to TV? That is the question. That's a lot of toys, so I think I'd have to say bye-bye, TV. Would you rather get a
new
video game every day, but only get to play video games for 5 minutes a day? Or get to play video games for as long as you want, but only play one
old
version of Mario Kart? I can only throw so many banana peels, so... Okay, here is the last question. Would you rather get one spoonful of ice cream in a
new
clean bowl, or get three huge scoops of ice cream that you have to eat out of an
old
rusty can? No rusty road ice cream for me. Thank you, though. Well, that was a lot of fun. Thank you all for playing
New
or
Old.
God's Story, Anna and Simeon. So part of God's story is about Anna and Simeon, and it goes like this. For hundreds and hundreds of years, God had been promising his family, the Israelites, a rescuer and king. He told them that this rescuer would come as a baby and would be his very own son. People waited a long, long, long time for the Savior to come. Lots waited their whole lives. Well, when Jesus was finally born, there was a man living in Jerusalem named Simeon. He was especially excited for God's promised king because he loved God and followed him with his whole heart. He even got to talk to God through the Holy Spirit. Nowadays, anybody who follows Jesus gets to talk to the Holy Spirit anytime. But before Jesus was born, the Holy Spirit only talked to some people, and Simeon was one of them. Anyway, one of the things the Holy Spirit told Simeon was that the baby king would be born while Simeon was still alive. Since God had been promising the rescuer for hundreds of years, this was a big deal. Simeon would actually get to meet God's rescuer, just didn't know when. On the night of Jesus' birth, angels appeared to shepherds and announced Jesus' arrival. They excitedly ran out, telling everyone they knew. But remember, there weren't phones or internet back then, so not everyone knew that Jesus had been born, including Simeon. A little while after Jesus' birth, the Holy Spirit told Simeon to go to the temple. He may not have known why, but he obeyed anyway. Good thing he did, because while Simeon was at the temple, Mary and Joseph brought their new baby Jesus to the temple too, to dedicate him to God. As soon as Simeon saw Mary and Joseph with Jesus, he knew who Jesus was. We don't know exactly how he knew, but he did. Simeon took Jesus in his arms and said, "Lord, you are the king over all. Now let me, your servant, go in peace. That is what you promised. With my own eyes, I have seen what you have done to save your people." See, Simeon was getting pretty old, and meeting Jesus was the one thing he wanted in his life. Now that the rescuer was here, he was ready to die in peace. There was someone else in the temple that day, a woman named Anna. For many years, she had stayed at the temple day and night, worshiping God through fasting and prayer and talking to God through the Holy Spirit, like Simeon. The Bible doesn't tell us exactly how long she'd been there, but by this time, she was 84 years old. She knew God well, and like Simeon, she had been waiting for the king God had promised. Sure enough, Anna came by just as Simeon was talking to Mary and Joseph. Immediately, she praised God. The king was finally here, just as God promised. When Simeon and Anna met Jesus, they were overcome with joy. The Bible tells us that faith is being sure of what we hope for. It is being sure of what we do not see. Simeon and Anna were sure that God had promised to send a rescuer. They were sure he was coming. And when they saw Jesus, they were sure the rescuer had arrived. All because they had faith that God keeps his promises. And that's the story of Anna and Simeon.
Simeon and Anna were at the temple on the day that Jesus was going to be dedicated because God revealed that to them. He told them that that was going to happen. And we know that God keeps his promise. So when he had made a promise to Simeon that the Savior would be born during his life, he kept that promise. Now I have a question. How do you think Anna and Simeon felt waiting to meet the Savior that God had promised? What do you think? Maybe they felt excited. Maybe they felt hopeful. Maybe they didn't know what to think. But I imagine that as they met baby Jesus in the temple that day, they probably felt grateful. Grateful that God would keep his promise to them and allow them to meet this wonderful rescuer that he had promised. Now, the video we watched introduced us to a word that maybe you've heard before, but maybe you don't know exactly what it means. That word is faith. And faith means being sure of what we hope for. It means being sure of what the things that we can't see. Well, that's what Anna and Simeon had. They both knew God's word, and they knew that God had promised to send a Savior. They had faith that God was not only going to send a Savior to the world, but also that they would get to meet him. So imagine their joy when they finally met that brand new baby, the Savior. The one who is going to rescue the whole world. Since it's the end of the year, I thought it would be fun to look back at this past year and remember some of the things that you've been able to do as a family. And it allows you to stop and give thanks for all of the ways that God has blessed you. Some people start the new year with resolutions and things that they want to start doing in the new year, and that's a great thing. But this year, I'd like us to do some New Year's reflections. We started it last year, so I figured let's keep it going. So I'm going to give you some time as a family to talk about this past year. But before you do that, I want to pray for all of us. God, thank you for all of the ways that you have been Emmanuel, God with us this past year. You've been with us when we stayed home and when we traveled to new places. You were with us at school, at the park, when we go to church, and when we went to sleep at night. As we look back over this past year, we are so thankful of how you take care of us. As we start this new year, God, we pray that you would help us remember that you are always with us, no matter what. Thank you for your love for us, and we love you, God. Amen. Happy New Year, everyone!
Friends, I have a super funny riddle for you today. Why do giraffes get bad grades? Because their heads are always in the clouds. Bye, friends. See you next year.